Multifamily and mixed-use developments are one of the fastest growing sectors in the building industry. In 2022, multifamily housing accounted for 34% of all new residential construction, the highest annual total since the 1980s. In this video, we're going to discuss considerations for starting your building project. I'm Josh Reckemer, an architect here at Newman Munson. Over the years, we've worked with many housing developers in the Iowa City and Des Moines areas, teaching us some key lessons. Design of these project types is all about managing choices, hitting your target, and finding the right opportunities to do something special. We won't focus on building amenities here, but those have also become an expectation and attractor. In this video, we'll share some of our experiences and discuss a few baseline tips for planning a multifamily or mixed-use development. Successful multifamily and mixed-use developments start with a clear target market. A development designed for college students can differ greatly from one designed for families. Engaging potential tenants to get their input is critical. We've used a number of methods and have found that simple surveys provide great results. But the method isn't as important as simply reaching out. We're always pleasantly surprised at the input provided, and it can't be understated how much value it brings to a project. For students, larger bedrooms to accommodate desks and/or keyless entries and security are ideal. Family housing might have smaller bedrooms and larger living areas. Additionally, you might consider whether you want to attract buyers or renters, as this affects finishes and systems. For example, in-unit HVAC works well for condos, while rental properties benefit from accessible mechanical systems or closets for easier maintenance, off a shared corridor, for example. A clear picture of your target leads to more customized solutions. It helps guide and inform decision-making across the board, and it leads to a happy tenant that feels they've been heard. When planning a multifamily or mixed-use development, it's tempting to offer many unit types. However, minimizing unit types can lead to efficiencies, a cleaner design, streamlined construction, and better cost management. Standardization of units contributes to a regular grid and a uniform facade, enhancing appeal. Standardization aids financial planning, lessens the factors informing proformas and costs, it reduces risk, and it enhances feasibility. While unique conditions may necessitate different layouts, balance diversity and simplicity by focusing on unit types that fit your target market. Lastly, I'll just say, save customization for when it's absolutely necessary or to provide pop to the overall building. Rooftop penthouses are one such example. Fresh air and daylight are essential for well-being, and codes require bedrooms and living areas to have operable windows or access to daylight via expressed means. This makes exterior wall access a key design factor. Access to air and light affects unit layouts, building mass, and site capacity. In other words, how we manage exterior parts of the building relative to property lines and adjacent buildings. As another example, it's common for units on urban sites to tend towards smaller rooms, while suburban areas often result in larger spaces. In short, access to air and daylight drives many design decisions, so discussing daylighting goals and strategies early informs the design and helps longer-term viability of project choices. Balconies are highly desirable in multifamily or mixed-use developments. Residents in more dense types of buildings have always valued access to exterior space. Since the pandemic, the value of private outdoor spaces, whether shared space or an individual balcony associated with a unit, has only increased. Balconies are not only functional, but also can be an attractive addition, when done well, to break up a building's mass, making facades more lively and approachable. Many municipalities outline aspects of balcony safety and can go further to regulate the modulation of facades to avoid monolithic designs. Balconies add scale and texture, enhancing pedestrian friendliness. Even if not required, adding balconies is a good practice. They humanize the building's scale and offer valuable views and outdoor living spaces. When planning, consider color, materials, texture, and maintenance. Are you aiming to hide what is behind or make it more transparent? Your architect can guide you through these considerations. As a developer or building owner, following these practices is a good start in crafting a building with great market appeal and in financial planning. The practices mentioned have benefited developers in Iowa City and Des Moines markets. And such expertise and guidance is crucial to helping you realize a building that is not only interesting, but on target for your prospective tenants. We have a wealth of experience in these types of projects. Learn more by reading about the Market House in Iowa City and 219 East Grand in Des Moines. Thanks.